Need to turn off your VPN but don't know how? In this video, we will show you exactly how to disable your VPN on every device. Let's dive in. Why turn off your VPN? The top 5 reasons for turning off your VPN are playing online games and connecting to LAN servers, to access websites and applications that are available locally only, to access streaming platforms that can block VPNs, to access resources available over a local area network, LAN, to use local banking apps that do not work over a VPN. Method 1. Easiest way. VPN app. Let's start with the easiest method. If you're using a VPN app, open your VPN app. Look for the disconnect or off button on the main screen. Tap it. Method 2. Disable VPN on iPhone. For iPhone users, Apple has made this really easy in recent iOS versions. Here's what you do. Open your Settings app. Look for VPN right under Personal Hotspot. Toggle the switch to off. Method 3. Disable VPN on Android. Open Device Settings. Look for Connections or Network. Find VPN Settings. Select your active VPN connection. Toggle the switch off. It should turn gray when disabled. Method 4. Disable VPN on Windows. Click the Windows icon. Go to Settings. Select Network and Internet. Click on VPN from the left menu. Find your active VPN connection. Click Disconnect. Method 5. Disable VPN on Mac. Click the Apple icon in the top left corner. Choose System Settings. Click on VPN. Find your active VPN connection. Turn off the toggle switch. Better alternatives to disabling your VPN. Before you completely turn off your VPN, consider these smarter alternatives. Split tunneling. This is a game changer. You can set specific apps or websites to bypass the VPN while keeping everything else protected. Server switching. Sometimes you don't need to turn off your VPN entirely. Try connecting to a server in your home country or closer to your location to improve speeds while maintaining protection. And there you have it. How to disable your VPN on every device. Remember, the easiest way is always through your VPN app first. If that doesn't work, use the device-specific methods I showed you.